Hace algunas semanas entrevisté a uno de los doctores detrás del estudio que muchos consideran el más importante sobre una dieta 100% basada en plantas enteras, el estudio Broad, un ensayo controlado aleatorio que utiliza una dieta 100% basada en plantas enteras en una comunidad para tratar la obesidad, la cardiopatía isquémica o la diabetes. ¿Qué quería usted lograr con este estudio?
Well, it's a good question. So with this study, I really felt that by this point, when we started, which was back in 2014, the evidence is there. We have, I mean, Dr. Dean Ornish published in The Lancet in 1990, as you'll be aware, which is the biggest, the most widely read medical journal, I believe, in the world, about the power of, plant-based nutrition to reverse heart disease. We have people, Dr. McDougall's done work, Dr. Barnard's been publishing on diabetes. And so we had, literally years, decades of research evidence that this would be something effective. I mean, Dr. Esselstyn's published as well. So everyone's been publishing research, but it hasn't, for whatever reason, sort of made its way into mainstream medicine just yet. So I think for me, one of the things that I really wanted to show, and this is sort of an interesting little story. So obviously, when we were at the hospital, we had journal club. We were allowed to bring in an article, and we would present that article, and our peers, who would be, obviously the other young doctors, and also our senior colleagues would be at those meetings, and so they would have to sit there and listen to you. Talk about a study that you'd read. And so of course, I took in, Dr. Ornish's work, and I think Dr. Esselstyn's at one point as well. So hit them with it a few times. But and they were always they never criticized the results. But what they did say is, well, that's all well and good, but that works for this group of people over in America. We have this access, and probably these people have more money or more resources. And that's the kind of thing that, if I told my patients that, they would just, run away from me screaming or something. There's no way they would do that. And so that was really the main objection that we got when presenting these things. It wasn't that, oh, this wouldn't work. Or there was, you did get a little bit of, oh, that was a smaller study or something, a little bit of sort of methodological sniping, I suppose. But the main thing they would say is it's not applicable. It's not going to generalize to the New Zealand situation, and specifically the situation we have in Gisborne. And so for me, that was a big motivation to do the research, was not necessarily to show what kind of results we could be getting, because I mean, if that was what was going to grab people's attention, then you would think that, Dr. Esselstyn and Dr. Ornish's work specifically, would have really grabbed people and made the change. So kind of where I came from, it was I wanted to show that this would be something that people in Gisborne would actually be interested in doing, and they would be successful at it, and they would stick with it if they were given the right supports, and sort of see around that.
Espero que hayas disfrutado otro video de plantaderevolution.com. Si fue así, dale me gusta, déjame un comentario. No olvides suscribirte al canal y hacer clic en la campanita para recibir notificaciones y así saber cuándo subo un video. Y recuerda, lo aquí presentado no es una opinión, es ciencia.